full effects of the body blow of being turned down for recertification under the eco-management and audit scheme.
Southern Area Planning Meeting. Time stands still.
72% of our plants being planted in peat-free compost this year compared to 87% last year.
In local government, nobody can hear you scream.
Carbon dioxide emissions from council buildings are still too high at 2,455 tonnes.
What terrible episode in the lives of people in this room caused them to choose local government instead of life?
Cheer up, babes.
Sit next to Karen Cannon. She says that I...
think too deeply about things.
Karen, what would we have to show for our lives if the great recycling bank in the sky came for us? Our responsibility as human beings is to live every moment like it's our last.
Rubbish bus action plan meeting.
We need a catchy slogan for the front of the bus.
Rogers, one of those managers brought in to think outside the box. But some ideas are cack whether they're dreamt up inside or outside the box.
Let's brainstorm it. What is the rubbish bus for? To get out there and encourage people to reduce, reuse and recycle their rubbish.
So... how about 3R your R? The 3 R's being reduce, reuse and recycle, and the last R being rubbish. I realise that excludes compost, which begins with C, but 3R your R and do that thing with your C doesn't really work.
My next 4 suggestions are still half serious. The remaining 2 are openly satirical, including...
hooray! Here comes the rubbish bus.
I like it. That's a slogan I can work with.
No, I wasn't being... I only suggested it...
What you don't realise is that you drive women wild.
Barney Baird, bloke who shares my office.
They see you as unobtainable, like a priest. They think you're going to explode inside them as you sob tears of relief in their arms as you realise your years of lonely suffering are behind you.
Andrea was the last woman I lived with, in a non-living together sort of way. And that was a long time ago, so there's very little evidence that I...
drive women wild. You do, you know. You drive
but
them
he's on a roll. The horrors that await man without woman are laid out in graphic detail. Email from Karen Cannon. She's been pondering my deep remark at the Southern Area meeting and thinks it really is...
our responsibility to live every moment as if it's our last.
Did she misinterpret this as me coming on to her? Does she think I was proposing we live every moment together? As is usual on these occasions, the little-known fifth horseman of the apocalypse, Embarrassment, pays me a visit. Embarrassment gallops across the devastated landscape of my life, but, unlike the other 4, he comes when I least expect him. And when he comes, he brings with him my greatest hits. The 20 most embarrassing incidents of my life, all strung together, back-to-back, as if they all took place on the same day.
German romantic film, Manchester Baldry.
Goethe? They're composers, you moron! What right have you to be on the team if you don't even know that?
It's been a stressful day, so I shout at the telly.
Why do thick people enter quiz shows? Maybe they're too thick to know they're thick.
It's dismal from D.A.'s Mali, and thirdly for possible 5. Which part of the...
Waste Management Review isn't my idea of light bedtime reading, but I'm gripped by an article about a new eco-funeral from Sweden. The deceased is freeze-dried, shredded, and sprayed over a field. 2 fields if overweight. Could there be a better funeral for a local government recycling officer? Dream that I lead a strange double life. Recycling officer by day, I dump bald tyres and old mattresses in leafy glades by night. My double life gives me a thrill. I'm the naughty little boy I'm not allowed to be at work. Force myself to juice when depressed. Nutrition is the thin red line between health and disease as the body tries to claw its way back to stasis.
What were they doing on the team if they didn't even know that? This is University Challenge.
Mm-hmm.
I think thick people enter quiz shows because they're too thick to know they're thick. It's bad enough being thick, but to be so thick you don't know you're thick, it's Greek tragedy.
Builder arrives to start work on a mysterious stain on the bedroom ceiling. He's one of those builders who has 8 degrees.
You live on your own.
How do you know?
Everything's dead tidy. Verbal diarrhea's a giveaway too.
I'm a bit taken aback. I don't pretend my conversation could hold its own against Gore Vidal or Jonathan Miller, but this is the first time it's been described as...
verbal diarrhea.
Slanging match ensues.
I can withdraw my labour.
Builder threatens to withdraw his labour. I threaten him with the Federation of Master Builders. And since I've already given him a deposit for the materials, the Small Claims Court. We end up threatening each other with different articles of the Human Rights Act. Always expect the Human Rights Act to be invoked when you get into a dispute with a builder with 8 degrees.
You're a very shallow person, you know.
Wait! I'm sorry I threatened you with Article 4 of the Human Rights Act!
So Karen Cannon's wrong. I'm not deep. I'm shallow. And I suffer from...
verbal diarrhea.
I might not be able to do anything about my shallowness or my...
verbal diarrhea.
But I can do something about being...
dead tidy.
Go to work, leaving the washing up in the sink. I've embarked on a strange double life that echoes my dream. Fearless crusader against rubbish at work, my house will become a festering pit of squalor. I'm dispensing with the services of that well-known firm, Habit, Foible and Quirk.
Come on in, boys.
My yearly visit to the diversity workshop, a mere formality in my case. They know that I'm rock solid on gender, race and disability issues. Barney Baird, on the other hand, isn't. Sarah, the workshop leader, hardly bats an eyelid when he describes her as...
chief of the thought police.
Though Sarah stresses her role as a facilitator, she seems to facilitate a lot with Barney. At one point, she asks him what...
underpins your hostility to women.
I'm not hostile to women. I love women. That's my problem.
Right.
I love them too much. I'm the man who loves women.
That's very interesting, Barney. But I sense a lot of anger, and I'm wondering where it's coming from.
The man who loves women is soon laid bare as a serial philanderer whose wife finally had enough and kicked him out.
You don't understand. I love them all. I love them all.
Sorry, Barney. Can I call you back, Fran? I've got a man crying in my office. Now then, Martin, tell me something about yourself.
Sarah starts to facilitate with me. Having just witnessed her demolition of Barney, I'm careful to present myself as someone who's in...
A non-exploitative relationship that eschews reactionary gender politics. Or would be if I was in a relationship.
I see.
Andrea was a non-exploitative relationship eschewing reactionary gender politics. How many other relationships were scuppered by the People's Princess? I can't be the only bloke who didn't want to make the pilgrimage to London with a girlfriend who hadn't stopped crying for a week to glimpse a coffin containing someone I didn't know. There must be thousands of us cold, heartless bastards who suddenly found ourselves alone because we couldn't match our girlfriend's genuine outpouring of grief.
So the last person you lived with was 9 years ago?
In a non-living together kind of way.
Yeah.
This is like no diversity workshop I've ever attended. Maybe our workshop leader's experiencing some time-of-the-month issues.
So would I be wrong if I said you have a problem relating to women?
Ask him about his celibate priest routine. He relates then, all right. Mm. There he is, doing unattainable. And before you know it, they're queuing round the block. They think he's going to explode.
Right. So I was being unfair when I said you have a problem relating to women. You just have a problem relating to women in a meaningful, long-term relationship.
No, I don't get much casual sex either.
Right.
It's all starting to get too forensic for my taste when, phew, it's time to break. Though not before Sarah declares the session to be...
one of the most enjoyable I can remember for a very, very long time.
Waiting for me back in the office...
Martin, I'd like to introduce Brian Kent.
Hi.
Hi.
Brian Kent is to be our rubbish bus evangelist. According to Roger...
Brian has just the sort of people skills necessary to bring alive our bold project.
Beg to differ, Roger. The rubbish bus isn't at all bold. It's better than bold. It's totemic, emblematic of a seismic shift in local government thinking. Mm. The rubbish bus is the sort of project that makes local government such an exciting place to work in the 21st century.
Okay. The rubbish bus is the Guggenheim. The rubbish bus is Das Lied von der Erde. The rubbish bus does Taoist massage.
That's why it's so fantastic to be the very first rubbish bus evangelist in the history of the...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.